Hello friends, I am Panindra Gupta and if you like this video, please subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.
Hello friends, my name is Panindra and in this video, let us discuss about microsatellite and mini-satellite. So what are these microsatellite and mini-satellite? And this microsatellite is a type of repetitive DNA ranging it from 1 to 6 or more base pairs. And what is mean by this repetitive DNA? Repetitive DNA is nothing but if you take an example of prokaryotes, and in prokaryotes most of the genome, that is nothing but most of the DNA, will be more than the 99%. The content of that genome will be more than 99%, and this will be always found in the single way except in the ribosomal DNA and tRNA, that is nothing but transfer RNA genes, etc. And that content which is more than the 99% of the DNA which can be seen in the prokaryotes is nothing but the repetitive DNA. And this microsatellite is a type of repetitive DNA which is mainly ranging its length from 1 base pair to 6 base pair, or else more base pairs. So coming to the second point, these microsatellites are repetitive typically in 5 to 50 times. So normally where are these microsatellites are present? It is present in the genome of whether it may be human or else in the prokaryotes, in every organism it is present. So these microsatellites are repetitive typically 5 to 50 times. So normally this 5 to 50 times repetitives mainly forms a microsatellite, only one microsatellite. In that way, there are thousands of microsatellites which are mainly present in the genome of an organism. So these repetitions of 5 to 50 times mainly forms a single microsatellite, and that microsatellites will be present in the thousands in the genome of an organism, whether it may be human, animal, plant, etc., if you take any of the organism. So coming to the next point, the microsatellite DNA has higher mutation rate when compared to other DNA, which leads to high genetic diversity. So what is higher mutation rate? What do you mean by mutation? That is nothing but changes. Changing in the genetic code is known as mutation. So this high mutation rate takes place only in the microsatellite in such a way, it mainly leads to high genetic diversity. And coming to the next point, according to forensic genetical scientists, microsatellites are often referred as, what is the other name of these microsatellites? It is also known as short tandem repeats, which is abbreviated as STRS. Short tandem repeats, which was given, this name was given by the forensic genetical scientists, which you can see in the ICRI sets also. And coming to the next point, according to the plant genetical scientists, these microsatellites are also known as simple sequence repeats, which is so shortly abbreviated as SSRS. So according to the forensic genetical scientists, what is the other name given for the microsatellite? Short tandem repeats, which is abbreviated as STRS. But according to the plant genetical scientists, what is the other name which was given for the microsatellite? Simple sequence repeats, which is shortly abbreviated as SSRS. And coming to the next point, microsatellites and its longer cousin mini-satellites. So normally these microsatellites and mini-satellites are called as cousins because normally these both are then present in the human genome only. And microsatellites and its longer cousin mini-satellites together are classified as VNTR. So what is the abbreviation of this VNTR? Variable number of tandem repeats. So both of these together are classified as VNTR. And this VNTR is abbreviated as variable number of tandem repeats. And coming to the next point, the first microsatellite was characterized by Weller. So who is the scientist? Weller. Weller is the scientist who firstly characterized this microsatellite in 1984. For example, if you take TA, it is a dinucleated microsatellite. How you can say this is a dinucleated microsatellite? Because if you see here, what is TATA? What is this? This is a genetic sequence that is nothing but thymine, adenine, and then there is thymine, adenine. So all of these are known as nucleotides. That is nothing but, if you see in my previous video, I explained to you about nucleotides. That is nothing but the classification of nitrogenous bases, which consists of purines and pyrimidines. Purines consists of adenine and guanine, whereas if you take in the pyrimidines, it consists of thymine, uracil, and if you see here, thymine, adenine. So one, it consists of nucleotide of purine, and the other consists of nucleotide of pyrimidine. Pyrimidine is nothing but thymine. If you see my previous video, then you can get to know this example. To know this example, you have to watch my previous video, and the link of that video will be given in my description box. Please watch that. In such a way, you'll get to understand this example. So this is nothing but the genetic code, and it is said to be a dinucleotide microsatellite. Why it is said to be dinucleotide? Only two. because only two nucleotides has been taken. That is nothing but thymine and adenine. But if you see in the second example, GTC, it is a trinucleotide because we have three nucleotides. G is nothing but guanine, T is nothing but thymine, and C is nothing but cytosine. So three nucleotides are taken. So it is nothing but it is called as trinucleotide microsatellite. This is the diagram of microsatellite. So coming to the second one, mini satellites. Mini satellite is a type of repetitive DNA of which length ranges from 10 base pair to 60 base pairs. So normally if you see in the microsatellite, the size ranges from 1 base pair to 6 base pair or else more the size. But if you see here, the length ranges from 10 base pair to 60 base pairs, and it is a type of repetitive DNA. What is mean by repetitive DNA? I have said you before, it is in few, that is nothing but the content of the 99% of DNA will be present, then it is said to be as repetitive DNA. So coming to the second point, mini satellites are repeated typically 5 to 50 times, or how many times? 5 to 50 times. And all of the repetitions mainly forms a single mini satellite, and that mini satellites are present in the thousands in the genome of an organism. If you see in the microsatellite also, the same takes place. And if you see, coming to the next point, mini satellites are notable for high rate of mutation. Of course, if you see in the microsatellite also, it undergoes high rate of mutation and mainly shows high genetic diversity. I have written only high genetic diversity in the population. And the mini satellites are also present in the centromeres and telomeres of the chromosomes. So what are the centromeres and telomeres? So normally if you see my previous video, mitosis, I explained you in the mitosis. So what are the centromeres? Centromeres are nothing but it consists of two parts, left arm and right arm. So it consists of the two, that is nothing but it takes place in the chromosome. You can see the centromeres in the chromosome, that is nothing but it takes place in the formation of two arms, that is left arm and right arm, or else upper arm or lower arm. What are the telomeres? The diagram of this centromeres and telomeres will be given at the last of this explanation. So telomeres, what are these telomeres? Telomeres are nothing but it is present at the base of the, at the end of the chromosome, at the base part of the chromosome. So this I will explain you this in the picture. So coming to the next point, mini satellites also helps in the protection of the chromosomes from damage. So normally the centromeres and telomeres are mainly present in the chromosomes, right? You know the chromosome, you know the structure of the chromosome, like it is in the shape of the X. And mini satellites are also present, helps in protection of the chromosome from damage. So normally this chromosomal damage takes place, right? And these mini satellites mainly helps in the prevention of this damage. Okay, coming to the next point, some mini satellites contain a central sequence which is nothing but a core unit of genetical basis. And the best example is, if you see here, G G G C A G G A N G. And if you see here, G is nothing but guanine, cytosine, adenine, guanine, adenine, guanine. So what is this N? N is nothing but any nucleotide. N can be any base, that is nothing but any nitrogenous base of nucleotide. Whether it consists of adenine or else guanine, cytosine, thymine, uracil, it consists of anything. So N can be any base. If you keep here T, then it becomes tyrosine. All of this you can read along with the tyrosine. So coming to the next point, mini satellites consists of nucleotides of purines and pyrimidines. Exactly, if you see in the microsatellite also, it consists of purines and pyrimidines. And these purines and pyrimidines and the process of this mitosis will be given, the both of the links will be given in the description box. So the people who are interested, please open the link and watch the video. And in humans, 90% of microsatellites are found at the subtelomeric region of the chromosome. That is nothing but telomeric region is nothing but at the end part of the chromosome. So 90% of these microsatellites are mainly found at that region only. And these mini satellites was first discovered by A.R. Wyman and R. White in 1980. So who discovered this mini satellites? It was first discovered by A.R. Wyman and R. White in 1980. And this is the diagram of mini satellite. So the link of the mitosis, the link of the video of mitosis and also the video of nucleotides and nitrogenous bases will be given in the description box. So please do watch that video, in such a way you'll get the understand this example of this microsatellite and mini satellite. So thank you for watching this video, guys. If you like this video, please do like and subscribe. And if you have any doubts regarding this video, please comment in the comment box. And don't forget to press the bell icon. Thank you.